Hello, a little bit of a progress update on using SurrealDB and Rust. So I've been busy reading some of the Discord channel for SurrealDB and Rust, and I've learned a few things. If you come on here, it's probably a good idea to search for Rushmore. I believe he works for SurrealDB or as a contractor, I don't know, but one of the examples I was looking at, there were actually he provided three examples, which was really cool. So I've been making the queries. Let me explain my workflow. So what I do is I come in here and I experiment with my queries. Then with my Rust code, this deletes the driver, the team. So I've got two real tables and a third table, which is created when I use relate. So I'm using relate with Rust and it's Surreal QL. So within Surreal QL, you have something called relate. Relate then creates this additional table, even though I'm actually only really creating two tables to start with. So I'm creating a table called driver with five Formula One driver names in it. I'm creating another table called team with three Formula One team names in it. And then relate, which is taking the driver and linking it to a team and saying verbs. So we've got table, verb, table. And that's the way how it's commonly explained, is you've got a verb. So if you had author, it would be wrote and then article. So you'd have an author table and an article table, and you'd have wrote, and wrote would typically have the date of the article being written. So you could capture the current time or whatever. Okay, so what I do is let me just run this code. This is my setup. So before we run the code, I'll just quickly cover this. Standard Rust project. The database is mydatabase.db. That's actually in my upper directory. It's just in my document in documents forward slash Rust. So my project is SD4. See SD4 there. So if we do cargo run, I won't do quiet. Let's just see everything. And I've imported thing and value, which I don't need, it's telling me I don't need. So thing is a thing which is particular to SurrealDB. Okay, so that's my response, and that three was the answer to how many drivers won Monaco. Okay, so that's the actual first response. It's a bit messy because I've not passed it. This is the kind of the raw response. So okay. If it wasn't okay, it'd obviously be an error. You've got the response. So it's quite nested, which takes a bit of parsing, but you can see there's the driver name there, Verstappen, and name, Ricardo. They should all be in there as Perez. So Perez with a Z. So the first, when it creates them, you've got a Z for Perez. But if we go back and look at my, SurrealDB running in the background. I've got it running with debug just out of curiosity as well. So if we come across here, select star from driver, and you see Perez has now been changed to Perex. So my update succeeded. That variable, so the variables in this surrealist.app, the variables always stay there. So no matter what query you're running, you can kind of ignore that unless it's a query which uses it. I've been basically jumping on Discord, looking at examples, trying them out in SurrealDB, surrealist.app, and then if they work here, Then I jump back across to my main, to my code, and then I start trying to use the code, which you can see here is obviously in the lime green. I use that with a query. So typically I'm using db.query, but the other way of doing stuff, you've got .update and then you've got .content. And I'm not sure about this, but I think content is better when you've got a struct. Update a record with a specific ID. The ID is 1 because I'm just using integers for the ID. So hopefully I've shown here a couple more examples than what you might just ordinarily see on the kind of the introductory examples. So I've used relate. I'm selecting in. So you've got in or out with the graph edge. So let me just show you that. So down here, Explorer. So yeah, that one Monaco just gets created by, it's a table which just basically contains relationships. So here we've got three drivers. So we've got in, which is the driver name, and then out, which is the team. In and out. So in is the driver and out would be the team. So select driver from one Monaco. Select count. So count, probably if you're familiar with SQL, you're familiar with that, from driver, where obviously this is surreal QL because we've got the arrow and the greater than sign, one Monaco, group all. On some older examples, you might see group by all. You don't, that'll fail. You need just to use group all. Always use await. Then debug, and then the question mark, which bubbles up any errors, back up to here, where I'm just saying surreal DB result. So that's an enum. So we've actually got okay, which is unit, or implicit is the error handling. Right, so then at the end, I'm just passing OK. So if all that succeeds, we do get the OK. So it doesn't. So it just completes happily. So if you want to actually just take anything from this, update a record, that might be useful. And have a look at using relate. So you may not see many Rust examples using relate, actually, in the query. Back across to here. So team, driver, 5 drivers. The examples, example usage, so that's where I got the update from. There's something else called patch, which I tried to use but failed miserably. But the other thing I was looking at was if it exists, excuse me, but I don't actually think I've not actually found the need to use exist in my code. So I'd need to research that some more, because what I'm doing is just removing the table driver. Let's just so just out of curiosity, if I delete some of these tables and then I run my Rust code, just see if it fails. So driver, query. Before I do that, let me just show you patch. Patch did work in here, but I wasn't, through lack of expertise, it didn't work when I, let me run this in here instead of name driver 1. Put loads of Z's on the end, and so we're going to patch it, and we're going to replace and the table. So I'm using a variable down here. The table is driver. No, I'm not using it. Sorry, tell a lie. So we're using field value. So field and value, those two go there. We're using replace, op, replace. Just run it. There you go, and you can see it's updated driver one. So if we go back across to select star from driver, you can see that driver one is now Perez. So that patch worked there, but I just wasn't able to successfully translate that across into my Rust so far. So the last thing to do, I was going to delete. Just doing your query, and we'll just do remove driver. Expected query to end. I'll remove table. That's it. Right, okay. So table driver should now have disappeared. So pretty sure we haven't got a table called driver anymore. Let me just refresh that. Yeah, good. Okay, it's gone. You will need to just refresh sometimes. Right, so let's run the Rust code and just see if we get an error. And that ran okay. So that ran. Let's just check to refresh again, and we should have a third table. Yeah, so we've got driver back. And it's got the drivers in it. So just to answer the question, or the question that I asked myself, we didn't have to use it if it exists. It didn't exist and it didn't panic. And that table did exist, and it removed them and then recreated them. So if it helps anyone, I can put this code, I'll probably put it into a gist on GitHub and then just put a link to it if anybody wants it. To be honest, if you just pause the video here, or actually pause the video there, that's this bit here has probably got everything that I can offer or add to what you might already have come across. If you've been using SurrealDB for a while, then this video is probably a bit too beginner level. But if you're just new to Surreal, or maybe you've been using Surreal just for a few days or a week or so, then this might be quite helpful to you. Well, I hope it is anyway. So this isn't very structured. I haven't put any subtitles on it, or I haven't done any fancy graphics. This really is just as is, and I'm just making this video to capture what I've kind of learned or discovered today and what I've been experimenting with. And I just wanted to really just show you how I go about experimenting and testing. So go on Discord, find some new commands or some new cool stuff. Try out, if I've got an existing database with some stuff in it, then I test out the query. If the query works here, then I will copy the query. And then I'll jump across to my Rust code, and then I'll do the query here, test it, use debug with the exclamation mark. The actual parsing, so if you want to look at how to actually parse it in Rust, then Jeremy Chone's video shows how to do that with an impl. I don't actually see the need to do that if you are only using your data, if you use your database for CRUD type of stuff, because you can use the REST API that you get with SurrealDB. If you're writing something for Axum or Rocket or Actix, then you may well want to then start doing parsing of the response. Okay, so this is just a final example where I have added a record. Now, a record is something which I've created, added struct, which is the record, which has an ID and a thing, which is the type, which comes from here. So you need to use SurrealDB SQL thing. And when you come to parse it, when you come to do the query, perform the query. And here we're using type thing. I still need to learn this a bit more, so I'm just kind of bringing this to your attention, but I'm not really doing a tutorial explaining it very well, so I'll skip over that. I'm using it and it works. So what I'm doing then is I'm using bind, and you can have more than one bind. So if you've got two variables like ID here and name, you do bind name, and then you can do bind ID. So you can chain them together. Then we use await, because we need to wait for it to complete. We expect, if we get an error, then we will say issue on await. Otherwise, what we do is we use take, and basically take checks. It's got zero in there because it's empty. So take checks that there is an iterator. I checked this on ChatGPT. So take returns an empty iterator. It's performing a check, basically, as I understand it. So once we've got res 4, response 4, we're basically doing match on response 4, and then we use dot first. So the two things here which I'm talking about aren't really specific to SurrealDB, because you can use take and you can use first anywhere in Rust. So what I'm using here is some record, if there's a record, and it can be, and it's of the format record with an ID and a thing, then we return OK with the string, the ID converted to a string. Probably easier just if I demonstrate this. So I'll just pause this here just to let you pause it if you're going to try and copy it, which you're welcome to do. Okay. And then if we run, cargo run, I've got my database already running in the background. I can show you that. See that there? In fact, we'll see something happen in a second once the Rust, since once cargo run completes. And then, yeah, you see that we had some action there. Okay, so we've got the responses that we had before, so response 1, 2, and 3. But here, the difference is driver 3 has been updated, so that is actually the table name, and that's the ID. So where I was using ID in the record struct, I could also use anything, really. Driver, we could add driver nationality, driver age, and so on. And then we could pass them and return them here. So this is my first attempt at actually, passing the response from SurrealDB. So I just thought that was interesting. And type thing, it converts a value into a record pointer definition. That's the official definition. So yeah, I just wanted to add that. It's kind of the last thing that, as a new user or beginner, I wanted to kind of understand or be able to do. So result is basically a vector, and then we use our struct name there. So if our struct was so our struct is called record. The one other thing I added was from string, which is what gets used. Remember, did I use it in the end or not? To string. No, I don't know. But that's how to pass a SurrealDB response. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon.